boy. Oh boy. So remember that old question we had? Is that Bloodborne 2? Oh, we had a very long conversation. Immediately after Blue Point got bought, I was immediately talking about like, okay, so yeah, they should probably be working on a Bloodborne remake of some kind, yeah? Yeah, maybe. That'd be great. But there was a big talk of like, what else could they be doing, right? In what other situations is everyone is still saying, oh, they're going to be making a Metal Gear, they're going to be doing this, they're going to be doing that. And it was like, I don't see there being a lot of possibility there. And since Sony has been so awkwardly coy about Bloodborne, it seems like, I don't know, there seems to be a lot of convenient shit going down. There's some stuff in here that I've heard some very hot takes regarding Blue Point making a Bloodborne 2 that I think is funny because I think people are jumping way beyond the scope of where they even realize where that conclusion's coming from. Let's start from the beginning. The beginning of this is that Bloodborne PC port has been rumored forever. Every week, it feels like there is a new Bloodborne PC port rumor of some kind. However, in some fashion, there was just recently a God of War PC announcement. These dudes didn't even wait for like a Sony experience, right? They didn't even wait for a state of play. They're just like, hey, God of War PC, see you in January. It's like, holy shit, okay. All right, neat. Well, we're excited, boy. And that's great. That's actually genuinely awesome. I can't wait. But it's just more fuel to the fire that Sony is really digging their feet deep into that sand that, oh God, we can't sell as many PlayStation 5s as we would like to. We're selling a shit ton of them. We're doing just fine, but we could be doing way more. So what do we do if we can't sell more systems? The number one answer is to reach out to PC with some of your classic titles. That's a way to recoup some of the revenue, which is probably going into the fact that they're losing money on the sales of PlayStation 5s still to this day, you know? But they have to make that up in software. That's how the industry kind of works when consoles come out. Bloodborne PC port has been rumored for so long. Like, this is at least a couple of years, dude, that people have been rumoring and talking about and making fake leaks and fake posts and screen caps and all this bullshit, and nothing has come from any sources that are like credible. Something would always go down a pipeline or a daisy chain of like, so where did the information actually come from? Oh, it was a random 4chan post. God damn it. It was always a moment where it seemed like there might be something really cool on the horizon for Bloodborne PC, and then it just goes absolutely nowhere. And it's like, so wait a minute, who was actually saying what and where did it come from? It was total bullshit. It was absolute total bullshit. This time is different. This specific situation is not a dude, trust me sort of moment. So recently, there was some notable industry insiders that were posting on Twitter saying that, wow, I'm getting word that Blue Point's next game might be a visit back to Yharnam. And a couple of other people sort of backing that shit up saying, the same thing, where it's like, oh yeah, I heard the same thing too. One thing is one thing and that's it. One thing isn't causing smoke. There's cause for interest, but there's no forest fire yet. Few days pass, and again, Nick from Xbox Era was hearing the exact same stuff, that there's been rumors floating around about Blue Point and Bloodborne, and that I have been told by a couple of different sources, a couple of different things about Bloodborne, but I've been told that there's a PC port that's technically already done, and I believe that Blue Point is doing a sequel. And there also might be a console remaster of the first one, which is a triple dip of epic fucking proportions. So PC port already being finished, probably saved for something, a potential sequel, and a Demon's Souls-like remaster of the first game. That's a lot. Here's the crazy thing, is that normally this would be like, that's too good to be true, that's too much crazy stuff happening. It sounds like a lot for one studio, and it's worth pointing out that beyond a number of recent rumors, unsubstantiated words of various Bloodborne projects have been circling for many years, and there's no guarantee that there's one of any extra weight to the latest claims. The only difference is that I did check on the first initial reveal of this that was happening on like the leak forums and stuff like that on Reddit. And yeah, the threads weren't taken down because 1 week before, people were saying similar things about Bloodborne and Blue Point. And then a week later, this dude shows up and he's saying, okay, so I'm hearing similar stuff, and apparently it might be coming from an even different source. So now if rumors are coming from one end of the spectrum that some people are hearing, and then they're coming from another end of the spectrum, and then the dude proves it, where the dude actually is like, yeah, here's the screenshots. Here's the date on the screenshots. This is what's happening. Or this is the information I got and when I got it. To me, that's like, okay, well, that's interesting. Of all the other Bloodborne rumors and all the other Bloodborne hopes and all the PC port wants and all that kind of stuff that's been happening over the past few years, this is the only time and situation where there's been multiple people saying it from different facets, from different ends of the, you know, the industry spectrum. So at that point, there's definitely smoke, right? There's smoke is in the air. It smells weird. Don't know exactly what it means. I would like to think it smells delicious and gothic and Victorian and Lovecraftian. I would like to say so, but it's still 100% a rumor. But when you got several outlets saying the same thing, coming from different timeframes and sources, I don't know, man. To me, there could be fire there somewhere. But here's the crazy thing, because this got a lot of traction. A lot of sites reported on this, and a lot of people were talking about it. We also talked about what Bluepoint had said in the previous interview, where Bluepoint was being interviewed by Sony. And Bluepoint specifically did not say new IP. They were talking about, I think they said original content. One of their projects is like original content, which already threw up a red flag where it's like, well, if they were making their own thing that belonged to them and it's now like a Sony thing, why would they say original content? Why wouldn't they just say new IP? If they were working on a new IP, they would just say new IP and be like, hey, we're doing our own brand new IP. It's gonna be great. Saying original content is super weird. Where that's like, huh, what do you mean by original content? Are you making the final Archstone for Demon Souls? What's going on there? Well, it's been a while since Demon Souls has come out, so I mean, and then we're definitely pushing the scape of how long the updatable content for that game should be going. So I'm thinking it's probably not going to be Final Archstone for Demon's Souls. Because even Bloodborne's DLC was delayed by like a lot. We're way beyond that scope with Demon's Souls by this point. Yeah, so they do have multiple teams. This was before this happened. It was rumored that one team is doing a remake, like a popular franchise remake, and one team is doing the original content thing. And then this rumor drops like a week later. And the rumor now says that Bluepoint is possibly doing a console remaster of the first game and also a sequel. Huh, that's convenient. That's weird that was exactly what I think even Bluepoint interviews were saying. So there's definitely some smoke here, right? There's definitely some shit that's definitely happening, and they have a lot of work done. So here's the crazy part. The crazy part about all this shit is that a lot of people are like, Bluepoint making a Bloodborne 2? I don't trust those guys to continue Bloodborne, right? I don't trust Bluepoint to be the ones to continue this game series. If this is true, this is terrible news type shit, right? If any of this is true, which I'm saying a lot over the past hour, I don't see there being a situation in hell, absolute zero chance, that if Bloodborne 2 is being made by Bluepoint, that the game is not designed artistically and designed and supervised directly by the creators of the original game. And a lot of people are like, well, games don't work that way. You just give it to a dev and you make it. No. Oh, sir, no. Because we have a lot of history with this. Let me give you the title of a little game called Street Fighter 4 and Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Let me just tell you what the situation of those games was. At the time Capcom was bringing back fighting games back in the late 2000s, Capcom did not have many fighting game devs. They didn't have a lot of people that knew how to make fighting games. But they had some designers and some developers that wanted to put together the roots and the foundation of how that game was going to play. However, they just didn't have the programmers to do it. So they hired companies to do it for them. They hired Dimps to put together Street Fighter 4. Here's a great example. Nintendo hired Bandai Namco to put together Smash 4, as well as Smash Ultimate. Capcom hired Aiding to put together Marvel vs. Capcom 3 and Ultimate Marvel 3, and Tatsunoko vs. Capcom. Capcom was not the developers of those games, but they were the creative driving factors. They were the ones that came up with all the ideas of how characters would play and how systems would work, and they worked with the other guys to make that stuff actually happen. These companies were hired, but the games were designed still at their respective creative landscapes, right? This is the future where I see. I love FromSoft, right? I love them. They make some of my favorite games out there. They arguably have some of the greatest level design in video game history and some of the best enemy encounters that you can possibly have in the history of the medium. Their games look rough. Bloodborne is an amazing game held specifically by its art aesthetic. Everything else, engineering-wise and technically, is held together by duct tape and string. And unfortunately, it hasn't changed much since Bloodborne other than just better frame rates and resolution. The art has always carried their games. Luckily, if you were to be in a situation where Sony is like, yo, listen, FromSoft, we're gonna do Bloodborne 2, you guys ready? And FromSoft is like, we're ready, man. Then like, we're fresh and we're prepped. We're looking good and we're sharp. We just made this, we're working on this Elden Ring game. Want to take a look at it? And Sony's like, let me see it. Put it into my eyes, we're gonna make so much fucking money. Whoa. Sony looks at Elden Ring, they're like, you know what? That game looks very fun. That game is probably gonna sell very well. But we got a big problem, FromSoft. These other dudes just remade one of your games and it looks 10 times better. We have a big issue that the guys that remade your game made a better looking game that is so much better looking than almost anything else. Like on a pure graphical fidelity level, like these guys over here are the engineering and graphical powerhouse. These dudes can put together a fucking game. This shit looks really cool, but if this is going to be our big next generational leap, we're gonna take one of the biggest franchises from the PlayStation 4 and jump into the PS5 and it's gonna look like a little bit better Elden Ring, I'd imagine Sony would be an immediate fool. Our system is about the highest graphical quality. Our exclusives are about pushing the boundaries of what's possible in video game, like that kind of, I am not making this shit up as in I am telling you what I feel. This is what Sony 100% feels about stuff. Potentially, if Bluepoint was doing a console remaster and there was a Bloodborne 2 out there, and if FromSoft was the ones doing Bloodborne 2, suddenly the sequel looks worse than the console remaster? Like that, so this is the situation where I genuinely disagree with some people that say that Bluepoint can't do Bloodborne 2. That doesn't work. They don't have the talent, or they have no idea what they're doing. Like, right, but this is not a situation like Demon's Souls. This is not. Where it's like, oh, you have our blessing. Bye, right? And they aggressively keep as much in there as possible, right? They aggressively try to keep as much Demon's Souls DNA in there as possible, including all the janky bosses and shit. No, in my eyes, this situation is, no, they work directly together, right? Miyazaki and crew design the game still, design how it feels, and have notes about how Bluepoint would put this shit together. And if there would be a Bloodborne 2, imagine it being on the graphical fidelity of Demon's Souls, but being a game that is made by, you know, Miyazaki and crew. To me, that's like the best case scenario. Here's my problem with this rumor. Even though it came from several sources and multiple different ends of the industry were saying the exact same thing, that yeah, potential sequel, potential remake, and potentially PC version. If all this shit is actually true, it would definitely make sense of Sony being so aggressively quiet. So brutally quiet about Bloodborne. Why they haven't mentioned anything. What is the reasoning behind you absolutely being completely deaf-eared to one of the best-selling games of the previous generation? Like, that shit is the part that makes no goddamn sense. The problem with the rumor is that you need to start giving you hope. I agree. I completely agree that this shit is too good to be true, and I don't like that multiple people are saying similar stuff. I don't like that. That pisses me off. Why are you giving people hope? Why? Why would you get people like me and all the other people that just want a freaking PC version of Bloodborne, the game to run in something that's not 28 frames a second, why would you give us this kind of hope? Why would multiple people through multiple outlets that have a history of, you know, dropping industry information, all drop similar industry information at different times? Why? Why would you do that? About something that so many people want. Why would you do that? We were already fully convinced that Sony hates Bloodborne and hates Bloodborne fans. We were convinced. You can't go telling us that they're going to PC version the first game, also remake the first game, and then make a Bloodborne 2? Holy shit!